Before we start the video, I want to mention that I actually just started a Patreon page. If you're a big fan of my channel, you want to see me continue making videos for a long time, then please donate. The link will be in the description down below. It's mainly to keep up with YouTube's fluctuating ad rates and hard-to-follow algorithm that a Patreon page is kind of necessary to just have a consistent cash flow. So if you are a big fan of my channel and you want to see me continue making videos for a long time, then please donate. The link will be in the description down below. With that out of the way, let's start the video. Marvel and DC have been rivals for decades, and in terms of the movies, they were kind of on equal footing. DC was actually considered a little bit better at making movies. That is until the Marvel Cinematic Universe came around, which completely blew DC out of the water, becoming the biggest superhero and biggest movie franchise of all time. DC tried to catch up, starting with Man of Steel in 2013, but they tried to get there way too quickly, and by the time the big team up came around, Justice League, it completely failed, losing the studio a lot of money. And while a lot of that was because of behind the scenes issues, it also is because of the structure of the cinematic universe, which wasn't nearly as well defined as the Marvel Cinematic Universe, which at this point is the gold standard for how to structure a universe, a coherent saga, over the course of over 20 films. And that's what I want to look at in this video. What if in an alternate universe, DC actually was the one that started the DCU, the DC Cinematic Universe, back in 2008 with the exact same structure that this universe's Marvel Cinematic Universe ended up having? So in this video, I'll be going over what I think the DCU could look like based off of what we would eventually get in what is now considered the Snyderverse, based off of the vision of Zack Snyder and whatever they were going for, but in a much more coherent structure. So let's begin with the first movie, which in the MCU is Iron Man, and in the DCU has to be Man of Steel. Before we start though, definitely let me know in the comments down below what you would structure it like, and you could be as free as possible. It doesn't need to be confined to the 23 movie format of the Marvel Cinematic Universe, so let me know how you would structure this universe in the comments down below, and with that out of the way, let's get right into it. So, at least partially how the MCU works is that there are three different trilogies, each one focusing on one of the big members of the Avengers, one of the main three, which are Iron Man, Captain America, and Thor, and in the DC Universe it's pretty clear who the big three are, otherwise known as the Trinity, Superman, Batman, and Wonder Woman, and those three will be getting trilogies. That does mean, however, that in terms of the other three founding members of the Justice League, Aquaman, Flash, and Cyborg, only one of them will be getting a movie in this saga, which is the counterpart to the Incredible Hulk. Meanwhile, the other two won't be getting anything, because I'm not going to be going over anything past Spider-Man Far From Home, like Black Widow or Hawkeye, and there will not be a Flash movie, and there will not be a Cyborg movie. However, there will be one Aquaman movie, and I chose Aquaman because in real life, he's the only one who actually got a movie. At least at this point, there is a Flash movie coming out next year, but that's so far, after any plan for the DCEU would have worked, so I had to go with Aquaman, even though I definitely think Flash deserves one. In a perfect world, Flash would get a movie, but here, he doesn't. So the counterpart to Iron Man is Man of Steel, or you could call it Superman Man of Steel, but we'll stick to Man of Steel for now, with no changes from the original really needed, and the counterpart to the Incredible Hulk is Aquaman, with the only really big change is that it's set before the events of Justice League, and thus is Arthur's first heroic adventure, while in the real-life DCEU, Aquaman took place after Justice League, and had a couple references to the movie as well. This time around, none of that would exist. So next up is Iron Man 2, meaning the counterpart would obviously have to be a Man of Steel sequel, something that we never actually got in real life. The closest thing is Batman vs. Superman Dawn of Justice, but I can't do that because there wasn't an Iron Man Captain America movie before his own movie and before they met in the Avengers, but Iron Man 2 did actually debut a founding member of the Justice League, so instead of a Batman vs. Superman fight, this movie, which I would call Man of Steel Dawn of Justice because why not, would feature a race between Superman and the Flash, which would be the debut for the Flash's character, and then the Flash could also even help Superman fight Lex Luthor in Doomsday, which we would see later on in the movie, as you can have basically the same thing, the same plot, just without Batman, and maybe Doomsday could look a little bit cooler, and also Lex Luthor, recast him, those are things that I would definitely change, but in terms of structuring it like the MCU, Flash and Superman race, plus, because War Machine was a part of Iron Man 2, I would make Supergirl a part of this movie. Next up is Thor, with its counterpart being Wonder Woman, and I chose Wonder Woman instead of Batman because it makes more sense for Batman to be a Captain America counterpart. We will see that much later in Phase 3. For now though, Wonder Woman, this version of the movie would be the exact same. Basically, the only difference is that because Thor saw the debut of another founding member of the Justice League in Hawkeye, this movie would see the founding member Cyborg debuting in a cameo, because Hawkeye also had just a cameo. This would happen either in the end credits scene or like right at the end of the movie, because there's no way for Cyborg to fit into the main storyline. But aside from that, the movie would basically be the exact same thing. And finally, there's the Batman, which is the counterpart to Captain America the First Avenger, which would have basically been the movie that they were planning for Ben Affleck, that Ben Affleck would have written and maybe directed. I think the main villain would have been Deathstroke. A lot of it would have taken place in Arkham Asylum, and it would have showcased Bruce Wayne's brutality, his newfound brutality, maybe because of the recent murdering of Jason Todd, which we'll get back to later in the next phase. For now though, that's the end of Phase 1, aside from obviously the big team up, which would be Justice League, which in this version of the world, it comes out in 2012 and it makes $1.5 billion, as it probably should have. The 2017 Justice League was absolute garbage. However, the 2021 Zack Snyder's Justice League was great, but it's way too long for the theaters. They would have never made a 4-hour cut to put in the theaters that came out in 2012. However, there still should be a balance between the two, like a 3-hour cut, a slightly under 3-hour cut of Zack Snyder's Justice League, which honestly, I think was entirely possible. There's a lot of scenes they could have cut out, and a lot of slow motion that they could have sped up to make it so that it's less than 3 hours, cutting an entire hour off. But the story of Zack Snyder's Justice League would be the story of Justice League, all exactly the same founding members, the same main villain, and the same main villain's motivation, with the same setup for the rest of the cinematic universe. I was really, really satisfied with how Zack Snyder's Justice League set it all up. I really wanted to see more of it. So in a perfect world, that's how it would have happened in 2012 with Justice League. Phase 2 begins with Iron Man 3, with the counterpart obviously being Man of Steel 3, which I would give the subtitle The Last Son of Krypton. In this movie, Superman would learn that Krypton wasn't destroyed naturally, it was destroyed by Brainiac. Yes, this would be the long overdue Superman movie with Brainiac as the main villain, which I can't believe still hasn't happened up until this point. They just always used Lex Luthor and General Zod, plus there hasn't been a Superman movie in 8 years since Man of Steel in 2013. Thor: The Dark World is generally accepted to be one of, if not the worst movies in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, so it makes sense that its counterpart in the DC Universe would be a real-life movie that is awful, Wonder Woman 1984. But this time around, I would change a couple of things. For one, it would take place in the present day, and the title 1984 would not be a reference to the year it takes place in. Instead, it would be a reference to the book 1984, which I cannot believe the real-life movie didn't reference, like, at all. Now, the first Batman movie focused on a Bruce Wayne, like, right after Jason Todd's death, and I did that because I think the second movie, which is the counterpart to Captain America the Winter Soldier, should have a very similar title, at the very least, to Captain America the Winter Soldier, and it would just be called Batman the Red Hood. The Winter Soldier and Red Hood are very similar characters, both sidekicks to the main hero. They later become villains, or they die, come back to life, become villains, and then after that they become heroes again. And that's what I want to see here, because the first movie focused on Bruce right after Jason's death. He's very brutal and he would have to calm that brutality. This movie would continue that story arc with Jason Todd being the main adversary that he would have to go up against. I also just love the Under the Red Hood storyline. The movie is incredible, so I would love to see a live action version of that. And I had to choose something. There's no basis in real life for what the second Batman movie in a Ben Affleck trilogy would look like, so this is just what I went with. The next movie in the MCU's second phase is Guardians of the Galaxy, and the counterpart would have to be Suicide Squad, as it's the main non-Justice League team in the DCU, plus both teams are like a group of criminals who then become slightly more heroic in the case of the Suicide Squad, but a lot more heroic in terms of the Guardians of the Galaxy. And while they aren't exactly the same, I think this is the clear counterpart. One thing I would change is that I would go with the original vision for Suicide Squad that David Ayer, the director, had. One, because it probably would have been better, but also because it has a larger connection to the saga. as I think it was either Joker or Enchantress, or maybe both of them together, who in that original script were trying to summon Steppenwolf, or to help him get to Earth before he would then eventually arrive in Justice League. Now this would be slightly different because Steppenwolf is dead at this point, killed in the first Justice League movie, but we could just replace Steppenwolf with Darkseid, and the movie could still be what they were intending to do back then, as Darkseid would make his debut here, much like Thanos made his... Well, he appeared in the end credits scene of The Avengers, but he made his full-speaking, big-role debut in Guardians of the Galaxy, so Darkseid would make his debut here as well. So then there's Avengers Age of Ultron, and the counterpart would be a movie called Justice League Panic in the Sky. There isn't really a specific reason for why that title is what it is, I just think it sounds cool, and I couldn't really think of anything else, but the main villains would be the Legion of Doom, as that is what they were planning for the second Justice League movie, but this would be very different from that movie. What they were planning was for the Legion of Doom to team up in order to summon Darkseid, and then Darkseid would kill Lois Lane and Superman would become evil, leading directly into the Nightmare world. There's a little bit to go before we get there, but for now, the Legion of Doom could still be the main villains, and the lineup would be Lex Luthor, Black Manta, Gorilla Grodd, Bane, and Cheetah, who would actually not summon Darkseid. Instead, they would summon Brainiac, or they would bring Brainiac back to life after he was destroyed in the third Man of Steel movie. As those five characters aren't really enough to be a threat for the Justice League, having Brainiac as like the main physical threat, I think works really well, as the Justice League, much like the Avengers, would be a lot larger this time around. Mera, Martian Manhunter, Hawkman, Hawkgirl, and Supergirl would all now be members of the Justice League. Plus, Robin would be there as well. The Tim Drake version of Robin would be present, but not a member, as, you know, Robin never really is. The final movie in Phase 2 of the Marvel Cinematic Universe is Ant-Man, and I think there's a pretty clear counterpart for that in the DCU, and that's a movie about the Atom. Ryan Choi, who is the second main Atom in the comics, there are three Atoms, the first one isn't really connected though, so Ryan Choi is the second one really, who appeared in Zack Snyder's Justice League, meaning the character has a basis in the Snyderverse, so we can give him a movie here, which works because Ant-Man and the Atom are counterparts anyway. Now Ryan Choi isn't the main Atom in the Justice League, that is Ray Palmer, but then again neither is Scott Lang, that would be Hank Pym. They decided to go with the newer version of Ant-Man, so it makes sense that they would go for the newer version of the Atom as well, as Ryan Choi would be the main Atom and the main character, with Ray Palmer acting as more of a mentor, and the former Atom from, you know, like back in the day. Finally, we get to Captain America Civil War in the beginning of Phase 3. Now, this movie is why I made it so that Batman is the counterpart to Captain America instead of Wonder Woman, as in the first movie, it would have made a lot more sense for it to be Wonder Woman, but here, as this one is much more plot significant, I made it Batman because Captain America Civil War focuses on a rift in the Avengers, and this movie would as well, with a large portion of it being a Batman vs. Superman fight, which would have been just much more impactful this late into the cinematic universe instead of their first meeting being the main one where they fight. This movie would be called Batman the Dark Nightmare, Nightmare obviously titled with a K, and would focus on a large portion of like a plot point that we briefly see in Batman vs. Superman, we briefly see in Zack Snyder's Justice League, of Batman seeing the future with the Flash's Speed Force powers. Like, he touches him while running and he sees a vision of the future. He sees the Nightmare timeline where Superman is evil, works for Darkseid, and they have enslaved the world. And this causes Bruce to be incredibly paranoid. This movie would also take inspiration from Justice League The Tower of Babel storyline, where Batman, being paranoid and scared of the Justice League's power, would create contingency plans to take them down, the main one being against Superman. This would cause a rift in the Justice League, there would be two teams that fight, but the main ones, the main characters who fight are Superman and Batman, and they go the separate ways at the end of the movie, which leads obviously to them being apart and not fighting as well as they would have once Darkseid does arrive. Obviously very similar to what happened in Avengers Infinity War, but we'll get to that when we get to that. The next movie is Doctor Strange, and the counterpart would be Shazam. One reason is because it exists in real life, so I had to include it. Not that I wouldn't have included it anyway, but also because both characters are magical, so it makes sense for Doctor Strange's counterpart to be Shazam. Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2's counterpart would have to be Suicide Squad Volume 2, based off of the real-life movie The Suicide Squad, which I changed to Volume 2 because, for one, it's a much better title, two, it differentiates it from the original movie much more, and also it makes it clear that it's a sequel, as this time around it would be a lot more of a direct sequel like Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 is. It would feature Deadshot, it would have Captain Boomerang in a much larger role, and while there would be a character or two from the original and here that die, in the end there would be like a main group of people. Deadshot, Rick Flag, Harley Quinn, King Shark could also be in the original one this time around, plus Captain Boomerang, who would survive into the big finale of the saga. So then there's Spider-Man Homecoming, which was one of the harder movies to place a counterpart for in this universe. Now, it's made pretty clear by Zack Snyder that the Robin that we see that is dead in the Batcave is Dick Grayson, but I don't think that would have, like, continued. Had they gone for a Batman franchise, they would have made it so that that's actually Jason Todd, because, I mean, he's a Robin who was killed by the Joker, that's his whole storyline. Meanwhile, Dick Grayson doesn't die and becomes Nightwing, a very popular and probably profitable character that they would have made a movie based off of. And that's what I would go through here. I think the Spider-Man Homecoming counterpart should be a Nightwing movie. And much like Spider-Man, Nightwing would have a very large role in this universe going forward. So then there's Thor Ragnarok, with the counterpart obviously being Wonder Woman 3, which I'm giving the title Wonder Woman Gods and Mortals, which is mostly an arbitrary title, but I think it sounds cool. It's from the comics, so I went with it. But also, because it has gods in the title, I think this movie could be focused on Wonder Woman meeting the Greek gods, learning about her true heritage, being the daughter of Zeus, maybe Donna Troy can be involved as well. And Aquaman, because Hulk had a large role in Thor Ragnarok, Aquaman would be in this as well, which makes sense because he does also have a connection to the Greek gods. His trident belonged to the son of Poseidon, so it makes sense. So then there's Black Panther, another movie that was pretty difficult to place, as really the only character who is similar to Black Panther, or at least the section of the world that is Aquaman and Atlantis. In fact, the movie Aquaman is very similar to the movie Black Panther. That comparison has been brought up a lot. So I can't go with that, Aquaman, because he's already had his own movie and he was a founding member of the Justice League. Instead, I'm going with a different section of the DC Universe that, if you haven't noticed, hasn't been included yet and definitely needs to, and that's the Green Lantern Corps, with Jon Stewart as the main Green Lantern. And I'm choosing Jon Stewart for three reasons. For one, he's my favorite Green Lantern. He's the Green Lantern that I grew up in Justice League Unlimited, so I'm choosing him for that reason. Second reason is that Zack Snyder also chose Jon Stewart as the main Green Lantern, or at least the first Green Lantern to appear in his universe. He even already had a character cast, and he was supposed to appear in Zack Snyder's Justice League. The other reason he didn't is because Warner Brothers didn't end up signing off on it, and he ended up being replaced by Martian Manhunter. The third reason I'm using Jon Stewart as the main character is that this is a counterpart to Black Panther, so it makes sense that the main character would be a black character. However, Hal Jordan and Guy Gardner would also appear just in much, much smaller roles and not as the main character of the movie. Although all three of them would end up appearing in the next movie, the counterpart to Avengers Infinity War. So this movie will be called Justice League Apocalypse War or Darkseid War, whichever one you prefer. I prefer Apocalypse War, but Darkseid War is the one that exists from the comics like Infinity War does, so if you want to go with that one, that is fine. From now on, I'll be calling it Apocalypse War, and it would basically just be what you think it is. Darkseid arrives on Earth, the Justice League fails to stop him, mostly due to being disbanded at this point. Darkseid takes control of Superman, kills dozens of heroes and villains, much like Thanos kills half of the Avengers and half of the universe, and leaves the heroes hopeless and defeated, or rather, the remaining heroes hopeless and defeated. Then in the next movie, they form a ragtag group of heroes to reverse everything, and the Flash would obviously have a very larger role in doing that, and I'll get to that when I get to that. There are two movies, however, in between Avengers Infinity War and Avengers Endgame. However, this time around, I had a very hard time making these two as significant as they were in the MCU. In the MCU, you have Ant-Man and the Wasp, which is significant really just because of the Quantum Realm and how that plays into Endgame. And then Captain Marvel, which is significant because Captain Marvel is incredibly powerful, and I don't think they would have defeated Thanos in the end had it not been for her help. Ant-Man and the Wasp has to be an Atom sequel, which I'm calling The Atom Brave New World, just because The Atom, or Ryan Choi, debuted in a comic book storyline called Brave New World. there isn't really any other reason other than that, and the way I'm making it so that his character or this movie is significant is that the main villain is Kronos, who can time travel, and Ray Palmer or Ryan Choi, one of them, gets his hands on the time travel device or technology that Kronos has. It's not complete, it's damaged or something, but by the time we get to Endgame, he uses that technology to assist the Flash in time traveling. That's really the only way I was able to make it so that this movie is significant in terms of the large saga and how they win in Endgame. But I think it works because Kronos is an Ant-Man villain, he time travels, and Flash, while lately he hasn't needed anything to assist him in time traveling, initially he did need the Cosmic Treadmill, so I think that Ryan Choi eventually creates the Cosmic Treadmill with the help of Barry Allen, and that's how they end up winning, but I'll get to that in a minute. And then we have Captain Marvel, which I have to replace with Birds of Prey, because Birds of Prey is a movie that does exist in the real-life DCEU, and both movies do feature female characters as the main heroes. This is not something that's really all that significant in this version of the DCEU, because Wonder Woman has her own trilogy, but, you know, what you gonna do? The one big change I would make is that, I mean, it's a huge change, in fact, Harley Quinn not included in this movie at all. She has her own movie franchise in Suicide Squad. There's no reason to include her here. And she's not a member of the Birds of Prey in the comics. At least, she wasn't until the release of this movie. Instead, Batgirl would be a part of this movie, or maybe Batgirl as Oracle. And Black Canary would be the point of view character of this movie, the main character that the movie is told through. Because of that, Green Arrow can be included as well, and that would be both of their introductions in this universe. In this movie, these characters aren't really ever going to be as significant to defeating Darkseid as Captain Marvel was to defeating Thanos, but I think for the most part this movie does fit, and I also, like I said, had to include it. And then we got to Avengers Endgame. The counterpart would be called Justice League Final Crisis, which I'm calling it that because the crisis in the comics that Darkseid was the main villain of was Final Crisis, which is kind of an awful storyline in the comics. It's just, it's real, real bad, so confusing, so hard to read. But it's a cool title, and although it won't be the Final Crisis, because, I mean, they haven't even gotten to any of the other crises, I think that it is a cool title for, like, the final movie in this saga. It's the Endgame, it's the Final Crisis. The plot would be very similar to Endgame. They're living in this apocalyptic future, which is actually a lot worse than it was in Endgame. Time travel is included, they go back to prevent the timeline and create a new timeline, and in the end there's this huge fight with like 30 or 40 heroes fighting Darkseid and his forces, and in the end they defeat him, but at the cost of the deaths of a couple heroes, including Batman, who is killed here because he was the main death in Final Crisis, the namesake of this movie. The Flash dies as well because he is the Black Widow counterpart, but also because a Flash always dies in a crisis. And he would have, like, he kind of would be the main character of this movie. He would be the last surviving character in the original timeline before he time travels back. He's the character who prevents this whole timeline from happening. But he would have to die as he does this, much like his death in Crisis on Infinite Earths. And finally, Spider-Man Far From Home, the epilogue to this saga, which kind of feels like a post-Infinity Saga movie, especially since basically everything in Phase 4 up until now has taken place before it chronologically, but it is technically considered a part of the Infinity Saga, so I'm including it here. This movie would obviously be a Nightwing sequel, which would deal with Batman's death, much like Captain America or Falcon and the Winter Soldier did. This will be a Battle for the Cowl movie, which is a comic book storyline, Batman Battle for the Cowl, following his death in Final Crisis. In this movie, Nightwing, Red Hood, and Robin, Tim Drake, would all fight over who should become the next Batman, while also dealing with a new Batman, Azrael, who would be the main villain. In the end, I can't make Nightwing the new Batman just because, for the franchise, it wouldn't make sense for the third movie in this trilogy to be called Batman and not Nightwing, but also because I don't really like the idea of Nightwing being the new Batman. I like the idea of Tim Drake being the new Batman, mostly because he doesn't really ever get his own title. Nightwing is Nightwing, Red Hood is Red Hood, and then Damian Wayne is Robin, while Tim Drake is stuck there in the middle, also Robin, kind of a Red Robin. I like the idea of Tim Drake replacing Batman as the new Batman, and also because he's kind of the counterpart to Falcon in this universe that is after the Infinity Saga, but still, that's what I'm going to be doing here, making Tim Drake the new Batman. So that's it for this video. It's a pretty long one, but I think it's kind of impressive how I put the entire saga into just one video, as when I did this with the Arrowverse, it took four videos. I don't remember why. I guess I delved more into the details of each movie, but this time around, I didn't really need to because most of the time, or a lot of the times, not most of the time, but a lot of the times, the movies already existed and they're just things I had to change. So that's really it for this video. Let me know in the comments down below what you would have done here, and if you like this video, make sure to leave a like, share, and subscribe. And again, sign up for my Patreon, please. I'm begging you. Not to seem desperate or anything, but I would love some more money and support. Anyway, bye.